These two kittens were born with a congenital issue called Swimmer's syndrome. The ligaments in their hind legs don't tighten up correctly as they grow, making it difficult to walk or get around. This condition is treatable through early intervention and physical therapy. But unfortunately, many never get that chance. Kittens born with Swimmer's syndrome are commonly euthanized due to shelter overcrowding and lack of resources to care for them. Thousands of kittens are born outside in Brooklyn every spring and summer. Some will make it to a shelter or a foster, but available space quickly fills up, which forces difficult decisions, especially for kittens who require extra care. So these are two of the lucky ones. Knowing that one day they'll be strong on their feet, we name them Fred and Ginger.
Nothing's impossible, I have found. When my chin is on the ground, I pick myself up, dust myself off, start all over again. Don't lose your confidence if you slip. Be grateful for a pleasant trip and pick yourself up, dust yourself off, start all over again.
The primary therapy for Swimmer's syndrome is to wrap the legs with medical tape so their hips, knees, and ankles are squared. This holds their legs in a natural position to support walking, running, and bunny kicks. We also do daily range of motion exercises to gently stretch the limb and bend each joint. Make sure to follow up with tummy rubs. After just 1 week of leg wrapping and physical therapy, Fred and Ginger were already seeing tremendous improvement in their mobility, which means they're now just free to do normal kitten stuff. I love watching kittens wrestle, run, and jump around, but for these two, it's extra special. We had lots of playtime and climbing exercises to build up their hind leg strength. Soon they were ready to battle every kitten's first nemesis, broom. Fred formed a strategic alliance with Dustpan. Fred and Ginger were separated from their feral mom at an early age, in part because they needed lots of hands-on medical care. So once they were healthy and vaccinated, we thought they might benefit from some time with Uncle Garfield. Most older cats don't have the patience to deal with high-energy kittens. But Garfield taught them a few lessons about boundaries. Monty is not so tolerant and prefers not to be upstaged by cute kittens, but she was willing to donate her pink poof cushion. And this is exactly why we always adopt kittens out in pairs, so they can keep each other company. It's not reasonable to expect that an older cat wants to share their space with a high-energy kitten. And with a solo kitten, it's your job to keep them entertained, which might be fun for a little while, until you've got work to do. These little nuggets finally began to find their voice. And it didn't take Ginger long to realize her scraggly meow was basically a room service bell. She napped in my lap every day, usually wrapped in her favorite blanket. Helping me answer emails and do other boring people stuff. It all went by so fast. With a little help from Uncle Garfield, Fred and Ginger were now confident house panthers, ready for their next chapter. We all need a little help early on to find our footing. Foster volunteers give cats the support and unconditional love they need to grow big and strong until they're ready to find their forever family.
Monica,
Yuri, come on, my dear.
The best way to give every kitten the care they deserve is to make sure every New Yorker has affordable access to spay-neuter services. That will result in fewer unwanted kittens fighting to survive outside, which means we'll have more resources to help each one.